In today's lesson, we're going to learn how the lift lever and the J-hook interact with each other so that the clock movement can strike the correct number of strikes on every hour. The lift lever, as pictured above, has three separate levers on it. Each one has a distinct purpose in the functioning of the clock movement. While the clock is running, but the strike train is not active, the count lever rests in a deep slot in the count wheel until it is activated. The maintenance lever rests in one of the two slots on the maintenance cam until it is activated. The warning wheel lever arrests the pin on the warning wheel until it is activated. Thus, the strike train is at rest. On the J-hook, as pictured above, the large L-shaped leg of the J-hook rests against the brass lever, which rests against the pin on the minute arbor. And the other lever on the J-hook rests under the maintenance lever of the lift lever. This is how the lift lever on an American striking kitchen clock movement is correctly set up. The count lever is sitting in a deep slot on the count wheel. The maintenance lever is sitting in a slot on the maintenance cam. And the warning wheel lever is arresting the pin on the warning wheel. This is done while setting up the strike train. The count wheel and the maintenance cam are easily set up on the lift lever, but the warning wheel may need to be advanced or backed off a tooth at a time to get it in the correct position after you've opened the plates a little bit, of course. Then the plates are opened carefully so you don't lose any of your wheel setup that you've already done, and then the fly is installed. Once checked, the plates are closed and the nuts on the pillars tighten once again. These next two pictures show a close-up of the lift lever set up correctly on an American kitchen clock, such brands as Ansonia, Sessions, New Haven, Waterbury, Welsh, Gilbert, etc. In this picture, the pin on the minute arbor is resting against the brass lever, and it is slowly moving it forwards. The other end of the brass lever is resting on the J-shaped lever of the J-hook and slowly lifting it. In this picture, the pin on the minute arbor moves the brass lever up until it almost disengages. The count lever rises up almost out of the deep slot. At the same time, the maintenance lever rises up in the slot on the maintenance cam, and the warning wheel lever slides up the warning wheel pin. In this picture, the pin on the minute arbor moves the brass lever forward until it disengages. This forces the other lever on the J-hook to raise the lift lever so that the count lever is raised out of its deep hole, and so the count lever starts to slide along the raised section on the count wheel. As soon as the count lever has cleared the deep slot, the maintenance lever has been raised out of its slot on the maintenance cam, and the maintenance cam starts to turn. At the same time, the warning wheel lever is lifted above the pin on the warning wheel, and it also starts to turn. The strike train has now become active, and the clock will soon begin to strike the hours. In this picture, while the count lever continues moving along the raised section of the count wheel, the maintenance cam and the warning wheel continue to turn. While the maintenance cam turns, the lever on the end of the hammer, which rests against one of the hammer pins on the maintenance cam, is pushed sideways till it drops off the pin and consequently strikes the gong. The wire spring, which is wound around the hammer and attached to the back plate, returns the hammer to its original position. The lever on the hammer engages with the next pin on the maintenance cam and will strike the gong again once it falls off the pin. Once the count lever reaches the end of the raised section on the count wheel, it drops back into a deep slot. Because this lever is dropped, the maintenance lever drops into a slot on the maintenance cam, and the warning wheel lever drops and arrests the pin on the warning wheel. The strike side train now has come to rest and will remain there until the minute arbor moves the brass lever over once again to its full extent. In next week's video, we finally put the movement back together again and test it. If you want to learn how to service, repair and restore 19th and 20th century mechanical clocks, then subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell.